very crisp challenge there. Little. Marvellous tackle. Edwards.
Jordan.
Goal news from Oldham.
It's a goal for Crawley Town. 25 minutes played. 1-1.
Cheers, Alan. Good judgment there to make that interception and clear the ball away. Back to him again. The away team have won their last 5 games. But on this ground against this opposition, to make it 6 is going to be a test.
It will be, but this is a team that tends to keep the ball and it tends to take the sting out of the situation, so that's what's helped them this year.
Got to be! Wonderful save from Fielding. Corner kick given. And the corner has been kept out here by the goalkeeper. Kieran Agar. Penalty at MK Dons.
It's a penalty for Gillingham. A slight delay as the ref clears the defenders. He steps up to take it. Chance. Oh, lovely. Straight down the middle. Always tough for goalkeeper.
Brilliant opening. In with a chance. Hit the post. Goodness, they needed him then to clear that. Unmarked now. He's lost his marker. Here's the chance. Dangerous moment. Takes the shot off. And it's in for the goal.
We just feel sorry for the keeper, really, the way he's hit that to his right. He's got no chance of getting a hand on it.
Substitution taking place. Going on the field is number 31.
Well, now it's 2-1. And Smith. Well, they're in a good position here. Here's Edwards. Oh, he's through. Got to be. That is a fantastic goal.
Well, I've missed a few of these in my time. It isn't as easy as it looks. But he made it look easy then, I've got to say.
And here is another angle on that goal. And it's 3-1. The goals keep on coming. Kieran Agar. Half-time whistle has gone. And it's 3-1 here. Well, what we've got here is a difficult situation for the home manager. The away team, probably the better side. And they now lead with that goal just before the interval by 2. And here we go. The referee's blown his whistle. And we're off for the second half. Morgan. Smith. Kieran Agar. Marlon Pack. Didn't hesitate, did he, with that challenge? Edwards. Going to be a substitution here for the home side. nicely lined up for the set-piece specialist here with this free kick. No difficulty for the ref here, because that should be a booking, and it is.
Well, you look at the ref and his view, he was right on top of it, so he knew what he wanted to do there.
Here's the shot from the free kick. Plenty of oohs from the crowd, but I think the goalkeeper had it covered. It was an ambitious try.
Yeah, it was, and perhaps a little bit greedy, a bit selfish as well.
Kieran Agar. Substitute coming on for the away team here. The defender has dealt with the cross well. And Morgan.
Attention all season ticket holders.
It's a quick break. Oh, what an opportunity. In with a chance. In comes the challenge. And that will go out of play. You can see it clearly has done. Final word on the midfield player, just been replaced, Alan, and a substitution now.
Well, it was a really poor performance from him, a player that is capable of much better. So maybe a one-off, he'll be hoping so.
How many late goals come in this competition? They want another one now.
I think this is going to be kitchen sink time, Martin, now. Plenty of long balls into the box, trying to get on those knockdowns.
Still striving to get back into this match. And that was a good effort, but it's going to be difficult.
I think they needed that to go in all truth, didn't they, to have any chance in this match.
Eastman. And they've got the ball back through a very good interception. Here's the chance. They've still got an opportunity here after the goalkeeper parried it. The home team about to make a change. Good width in the attack here, looking for a cross at the end of it. And in comes the header. He's had a crack.
Well, he's missed it, hasn't he? What a good chance that was for him.
It is all about the team, not the individuals, but forwards are the most individual players in many ways. Certainly single-minded, and he's got himself a goal, and he'll be happy tonight.
Yeah, well, the fans are happy with his contribution, and why not? He's played really well.
And he's headed it goalwards. Well, the corner wasn't defended at all well, but nor was the chance taken well.
No, and they will be relieved because they switched off the defenders there.
Here's Edwards. That's a decent save by the goalkeeper.
The official has indicated at least 5 minutes of added time.
And he's in there with a header, just over the top. Craig Eastman. there's the final whistle. Well, you don't have to dominate a game to win it. This game is proof of that.
You certainly don't. And the little scoreline in the top corner.
English Football League 1. Bradford City 0. Doncaster Rovers 1. Bristol City 1. Yeovil Town 3. Chesterfield 1. Port Vale 0.
Let's see who's playing who in the English Football League 1. The league leaders, Chesterfield, are at home to 19th placed Rochdale, while 2nd placed Oldham Athletic visit 16th placed Preston North End.
English Football League 1.
Let's look ahead to the next round of fixtures of the Johnstone's Paint Trophy. And in the tie of the round, Leighton Orient entertain Shrewsbury Town. Sheffield United host.
Johnstone's Paint Trophy. Barnsley 1, Newport County 1. Barnsley 1-4-3 on paint.
Let's look at the draw of the Johnstone's Paint Trophy. The Yeovil Town are at home to MK Dons. Oxford United entertain Preston North End. Rochdale host Bury. Bradford City are at home to Northampton Town. Crawley Town entertain Barnsley. Port Vale host Morecambe.
English Football League 1. Bradford City 2. Preston North End 1. Bristol City 1. Walsall 2. Colchester United 2.
Who's playing who in the NPower League 1? The league leaders, MK Dons, travel to 2nd placed Chesterfield. In 3rd place, Coventry. Let's see who's playing who in the English Football League 1. The league leaders, MK Dons, are at home to 23rd placed Fleetwood Town, while 2nd placed Coventry City entertain 5th placed Yeovil Town. In 3rd place, Chesterfield visit 18th placed Colchester United. 4th placed Leighton Orient travel to 6th placed Bradford City.